Okay, first of all, morning to all of you. By the grace of great Vaheguru and great Dhandashukur Andaraji, we will start our today's lecture, which is the most important lecture. And this lecture is about the type 1 and type 2 superconductor. What do you mean by what differentiate between type 1 and type 2? Now see, it has several names. Type 1 is also called a soft. It is called a soft superconductors, and it is also called a ideal. Okay. So there are three names, type 1 or ideal or soft. Similarly, the type 2 is also called a non-ideal, and it is also called a hard. It is also called a hard superconductors. Okay. Now let us come to the type 1. Sometimes a question can be asked by the examiner, differentiate between a soft and hard. Or differentiate between a type 1 and type 2, or differentiate between a ideal and a non-ideal. Okay. Now see, one important point is the soft or type 1 superconductors are the materials which obey Meissner effect strictly. What is Meissner effect? B is equal to 0, or we can say that the magnetization M is 0. Okay, M is 0. Now see, look at this graph. We will make a graph of M versus H. At this axis, on the H axis M is 0, and on the H axis M is 0, and on the M axis H is 0. Now see, we want M to be 0. Now see, at this value of critical field, at the value H is equal to Hc, when H is equal to Hc, then this value, then it suddenly drops, then it abruptly, I'll use the word abruptly, A-B-R-U-T-T-L-Y, abruptly drops, okay, M abruptly drops, okay, drops to a zero value, I'll get the point. Now see, it will from O to Hc, in this region the sample is in the superconducting state. It means the sample is a superconductor. But as we reach up to Hc, let us say we further increase or we just reach the value of Hc, let us say its value is 10 units. Okay, then it suddenly drops. It suddenly or abruptly drops. For the Hindi students, देखिए यहां से यहां तक वो क्या सैंपल हमारा क्या है सुपरकंडक्टिंग स्टेट. जैसे हम Hc वैल्यू पे आते हैं तो हम देखते हैं M की वैल्यू क्या हो जाती है, एकदम जीरो होती है. क्या होती है? एकदम जीरो फ्रॉम टॉप टू बॉटम. ओके, एंड फर्दर इन दिस स्टेट द सैंपल इज इन द नॉर्मल स्टेट. द सैंपल इज इन द नॉर्मल स्टेट मींस द सैंपल इज अ कंडक्टर. इट इज अ कंडक्टर. सो फ्रॉम दिस टू दिस सुपरकंडक्टिंग स्टेट, and from this to this, it's a normal state. Only main important point is it abruptly drops. The value of M abruptly drops to a abruptly drops from this value to the zero value as we increase the Hc, as we increase the value of the magnetic field. At the value of Hc, the value of M becomes zero. M becomes zero means B zero. M means magnetization. M is 0 means M 0 implies that the B is 0. Okay. M का मतलब होता है magnetization. Magnetization तो तभी होगा जब flux होगी. जब flux ही नहीं है तो magnetization किस चीज की? Are you getting my point? If we have some value of B, then it implies some value of the B will implies the some value of M. Okay. B 0 means the value of the M has also to be a zero. So that is why we have made a graph between M versus H. Now let us come to this graph. Okay, this is called a type 2 or hard or non-ideal. They do not obey Meissner effect strictly. But what's the meaning of strictly? Here it follows the Meissner effect strictly. Why? Because it abruptly drops. The value of the M abruptly drops to a zero value. Okay. Here we have used the word strictly. Okay. It means it obeys Mr. Factor strictly. But in this case, let us say this value is 10 and let us say this value is 20. From 0 to 10 value, from 0 to 10 value, the sample is in the superconducting state. It means sample is a superconductor. Okay. But as we increase the value of magnetic field from 10 to 11, so the sample is not in the normal state. The sample is in the mixed or vortex state. It means here in this state, the sample is partially conductor, partially superconductor. And as we increase the value of the magnetic field, let us say this value is 20. At the value of the 20 units, the value of the M will be 0. Value of the M will be 0 means value of P is 0. It means at this point, at the value of HC2, means the effect get obeyed. That is why we have used the word it does not obey. It does not obey Meissner effect strictly. It follows the Meissner effect strictly, but it does not obey the Meissner effect strictly because it has taken a range. It has taken a range of magnetic field. Are you getting my point? So that is what is called a hard. It is called a hard. Okay? हार्ड का मतलब जैसे हिंदी वालों को मैं बताऊं, जैसे कुछ बच्चे ढीठ नहीं होते, बात नहीं मानते, होते कि नहीं होते, ये वैसी बात है। इस पे काफी मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लगाया, तब जाके ये मीजर इफेक्ट माना। इस पे ए की वैल्यू पे हमारा एम की वैल्यू क्या आ गई? 0 आ गई। नेगेटिव पॉइंट इन दिस टाइप 2 और हार्ड सुपरकंडक्टर्स दे डस नॉट ऑबे मीजर इफेक्ट स्ट्रिक्टली। व्हाई? बिकॉज़ दे हैव टेकन अ रेंज, range of magnetic field between HC1 to HC2, and as we have given this range, HC2 is approximately 100 times HC, 100 times HC. So at this point, Meissner effect get satisfied. It means from here to here, from HC1 to HC2, the sample is in the partial conductor and partial superconductor. That is why we have written a word mixed or vortex state. And at this point and beyond HC2, the sample is in the normal state. I mean to say, in this state, the sample is a normal conductor. And the Meissner effect is obeyed at the point HC2. So this is all about the type 1 or type 2, or soft and hard, and ideal and non-ideal. And they obey Meissner effect strictly. They do not obey Meissner effect strictly. Obey dono mein ho raha hai. It follows Meissner effect. But only difference is, it follows Meissner effect strictly. It does not obey Meissner effect strictly. That is the point.
What is vortex?
Name vortex, mixed or vortex state. Name. We can call it as a mix. Some books write as it's a mix, or some books write it as a vortex state. Vortex means mix or vortex means partially state. But we cannot say it is a pure superconductor. We cannot say the sample is in the pure conducting state, or the sample is a pure conductor. Okay, partially conductor, partially superconductor. Okay, here the electrons also behave good behavior. Electrons are superconducting electrons as well as the conducting electrons. But here in this state, the electrons show the superconducting behavior, and in this state, the electron shows the normal conducting behavior. I mean to say, here the electrons will not show the value of resistance, but here the electrons show the value of resistance. Okay, so this is the difference. Kelly. यू गेटिंग दिस? नैन्सी समझ आया? तो चलो चलो प्रोसीड। बहुत ही तो बहुत सिंपल था लास्ट लेक्चर में भी बताया। दिस क्वेश्चन कैन बी आस्क्ड इन द कैपेसिटी ऑफ 3 और 4 मार्क्स। इन द कैपेसिटी ऑफ 3 और 4 3 और 4 मार्क्स में आ सकता है। अब जो करेंगे वो बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है। लंडन इक्वेशंस मोस्ट 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 इंपॉर्टेंट। Describe the Mieser factor and flux penetration. Okay, Mieser factor is also called a flux expulsion. Flux expulsion. Kelly, what is the meaning of Mieser effect? What do you mean by Mieser effect? What's the meaning of Mieser effect? Janice, what's the meaning of Mieser effect? Mieser factor means simple. Mieser effect kya hota hai? What is Mieser effect? B is equal to 0 inside the sample. B is equal to 0 inside the sample. Okay, so there are two scientists, F. London and H. London. You basically describe this equation and it is the most important topic. It is definitely asked by the exam. Definitely most important topic of the superconductivity. Okay. And it has been asked by the examiner in the capacity of 5 marks. 5 marks you have to. Okay, most important. Okay. Now see, as we discussed earlier, the superconducting material shows the perfect dimorphism. Shows the perfect dimorphism. And second is B is equal to 0. B is equal to 0 inside the sample. B is equal to 0 inside the sample, that is a part of the Mieser effect. That is a part of the Mieser effect. So please write. Mieser effect in superconductors can be explained if chi m is equal to minus 1. If chi m is equal to minus 1. Chi m is equal to minus 1. Why? Because chi m is equal to minus 1 shows the superconductor materials are the perfect diamagnetic material. Okay. Or m is equal to minus h. What is the same thing? Or m is equal to minus h. What is the same thing? However, it is a very drastic assumption. Drastic assumption. Full stop.
Drastic assumption.
Moreover, it tends to cut off further discussion of superconductors. Moreover, it tends to cut off the farther, F-A-R-T-H-E-R, further discussion of superconductors, particularly the flux penetration through thin films. Particularly the flux penetration. Particularly the flux penetration through thin films. Particularly the flux penetration through thin films. Next point. Particularly the flux penetration through thin films. Thin films. Film. FILMS. Film or sample. I mean to say for some of the samples shows Meissner effect, whereas some of the sample do not show Meissner effect. So it depends upon the dimension. If the dimension of the sample, is more, then it will show Meissner effect. If the dimension of the sample is less, then it will not show Meissner effect and it will show the flux penetration. So this is the difficulty. That which sample will show the Meissner effect and which sample will not show the Meissner effect. Okay. So decide. To remove this difficulty, F. London and H. London. To remove this difficulty, F. London and H. London in 1935. F. London and H. London in 1935 proposed two equations which can explain the Meissner effect. Which can easily explain Meissner effect as well as flux penetration. For this, let m is mass of an electron. Let m is a mass of an electron ns. What is ns? Ns is the number of superconducting electrons. Ns is the number of superconducting electrons per unit volume. What is Nn? Ns is valid for when the sample is in the superconducting state. Okay. And Nn is the number of conducting electrons per unit volume. This is valid for when the sample is in the normal state. Okay. Minus E. What is minus E? Minus E is the charge on electron. Vs is the drift velocity. Of superconducting electrons. Drift velocity of the superconducting electrons. And let us say E is the electric field. So we have defined the basic terms that we will use in the article. So Hindi wale ko samajh aa raha hai yaar? Aa raha hai na? समुन आ रहा है समझ आ रहा है ना? ठीक है, हाँ जी। एम होता है बेटा मास ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन प्लस कूपन। एम मास ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन होता है, एनएस क्या होता है नंबर ऑफ सुपर कंडक्टिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन्स पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम, एनएल क्या होता है कंडक्टिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन्स जब सेंट्रल हमारा नॉर्मल स्टेट पे होता है। minus is the charge of electron and Vs is for the velocity of the superconducting electrons. Okay. Number of normal electrons. Normal is more good. Normal. Because this N is for normal. Okay. Normal of electric current, same thing. But here we have used the N. So that is why I have taken normal. Okay. Normal means when the sample is in the normal state. When the sample is conductor. Okay. Minus E is the charge of electron. Vs is the velocity of superconducting electrons. And E is the electric field. Okay. Now please write the equation of motion for electron. The equation of motion for an electron inside a conductor. The equation of motion for an electron inside a conductor is given by
कंडक्टर में, ये इलेक्ट्रॉन की है जो कि कंडक्टर में, ठीक है?
This is the equation of a motion for an electron which is present inside a present inside a conductor. You are absent, I think. You are physically present, mentally absent. International. Are you getting this? Okay. Now let us will apply a special case for this. Okay, for the superconductors, this equation of motion will become. This is 1, 2, let us say this is 3. For superconductors. For superconductors. Equation 3 becomes. Then is how this equation will modify.
Differentiate this equation 5 with respect to time motion.
differentiate equation 5 with respect to time, with respect to t both sides. So what I'm getting? I'm getting d by dt of Js is equal to, now see, Ns is constant, E is constant, minus is constant. Constant, so I will take outside from the derivative minus Ns E d by dt of Js. Question number 6. Minus Ns E is treated as a constant. Okay, that will take it outside the L. Now what we will do?
Have you done this del
drop. Okay. Now see this del. If I will write this del into A, then this will become a curl of A. This will become a curl of A. Curl of A. Okay. Now what I will do? I will take the curl of equation 7 both side. I will take the curl of equation 7 both side. Take curl of equation 7 both sides. D by dt is equal to del cross Js. Del cross Js is called a curl of Js. Del cross Js is called a curl of Js. Just similarly, I have written over there. Operator over there. Del cross A is equal to curl of A. Okay. Del cross J is equal to, and this become ms e square by m. This is constant. So this become del cross E. Del cross E. Okay. I have taken a curl of equation 7 both sides. Okay. Let us. This is question number 8. This is question number 8. And we all know that, what is Maxwell's first equation? In the low classes, we have done the Maxwell equation. So what is Maxwell's first equation? Maxwell's first equation is L cross E is equal to minus curly B by curly T, or it is also called L cross E is equal to minus dB by dt. Okay. Minus dB by dt. Now we will use this equation 9 in equation 8. We'll use this equation 9 in equation 8. So the equation 8 becomes d by dt of del cross Js is equal to ms e square by m into minus dv by dt. So I will use, yes, minus dv by dt. Minus dv by dt. Okay. Now see, we have a both side derivative. We have a both side derivative. If I want to eliminate derivative, what I have to do? We'll take integrate. We'll take the integrate. This is equation number 5, right? Minus sign over here. Any doubt? Okay, so this is the minus sign. Minus ms e square by m. This is question number 10. Integrate equation 10. Integrate equation 10 with respect to time, both side. Integrate equation 10. Integrate equation 10. With respect to t, both sides. So what we get? We get del cross Js is equal to del cross Js is equal to kya aayega tumhara? Kya aayega? Minus ns e square by m into b. Okay. This will eliminate, d by dt, this will eliminate, okay, this will eliminate. So this is question number 11. This is question number 11. Now we will define B. We will define a B. So please write magnetic flux, let's see, B. Magnetic flux density B is related to vector potential A which is given by B is equal to del cross A. This is called flux. This is the assumption. This is the assumption or supposition. This is the assumption or supposition. Okay, B is equal to del cross A. This B is called a magnetic flux density and A is called a vector potential. A is called a vector potential. club into 11. Use 12 into 11. L cross Js is equal to minus Ns e square by m into L cross A. Or L cross Js is equal to L cross minus of Ns e square by m into A vector. Because this is a constant. So whether it will take, we can take inside or we can take outside the del, it hardly matters. ठीक है, constant को चाहे del के अंदर रखो चाहे del के बाहर रखो कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता. Okay, so it hardly matters. This is question number 13. Now compare question 13. तो मैंने इसको अंदर कर दिया इसको. Minus n s e square by n को del cross a के साथ मिला. ठीक है. Now compare the question 13. Left hand side part with the right hand side. Compare left hand side and right hand side part of equation 13. We get GS is equal to. Now see, this is del cross, this is del, this is del, this is cross, this is cross. It means this part will be equal to the this part. Okay. So Gs is equal to minus Ns e square by m into a vector, and this is called a London second equation. This is called a London second equation. Yes. This is called a London second equation. Now see, this is valid for superconductor. Both the equations, London first equation and London second equation, both equations are valid for the superconductor. Can you tell me the equation of conductor? What is the equation of conductor? Conductor ke liye kaun si equation hoti hai? Ohm's law. For the conductor, we have a equation which is called a Ohm's law, and we have a two forms of Ohm's law. One is called a V is equal to IR, that is also called a Ohm's law, and second is J is equal to sigma E. This is also called a Ohm's law, and this is valid for the conductor, and this is valid for the superconductor. Now compare this. What's the difference? Instead of E, we have a. E will be replaced by a. E is called electric field. A is called a vector potential. And sigma is get replaced by minus ns e square by m. So this is also an. This is a replacement. This is an replacement of the Ohm's law for the superconductor. This is the replacement of the Ohm's law for the superconductor. Why? Because Ohm's law do not valid for the superconductor. Ohm's law is only valid for the conductors. It will not valid for the superconductor. For the Hindi, in the Hindi students, जो Ohm's law है बेटा वो conductor के लिए लगता है, superconductor के लिए नहीं लगता. तो Ohm's law क्या होता है? ये होता है ना J equal to sigma E. इसको compare कीजिए. E की जगह पे क्या आ गया? A, which is called a vector potential. So hence we have derived the London first equation and London second equation, and this is the most important part of this unit. And as far as the syllabus is concerned and as far as the exams are concerned, this question is definitely asked by the exam in the final question.
Flux penetration,
but how? That is a part of the assignment. okay, you have to drive by yourself how these equations will combine to solve to successfully give the explanation about the Meissner effect and flux manipulation. What is Meissner effect? B is equal to 0 inside the sample. What is flux penetration? B is not equal to 0 inside the sample. That is for the thin films. Okay. Any doubt? International? Hindi walon ke liye? Thank you so much.